Father, we thank you very much for our Bible study today.
Baba wa adupe lowo yin lopolopo fun eko bibeli wa
toni. We thank you for the deep things you are revealing to us in the studies.
Adupe lowo yin fun awon ijile ti e fi han fun wa ninu eko na.
We thank you for the special studies we are going through now.
Adupe lowo yin fun eko akanse e ti an la koja bayi.
Thank you for the great examples you are showing us.
Adupe lowo yin fun awon apere to dara ti e fi han fun wa.
For the patterns you lay before us.
Fun awon apere ti e fi lele niwaju wa.
For people like us who lead by faith and walk by faith.
Fun iru awon eniyan oniru wa bi ti wa ti won gbe igbe aye igbagbo ti won si rinrin igbagbo.
For the great possibilities of the faith life.
Ati fun lile ise ti nbe ninu igbe aye igbagbo.
We pray, O Lord, as we come week after week, you will develop our faith in Jesus' name.
A n gbadura Oluwa ipe bi a o ti ma wa losose be le o mu igbagbo wa dagba ni oruko Jesu.
And we are praying that as we study today,
a n gbadura ipe bi a si n keko loni,
that your word will produce faith in every heart.
Wipe oro yin yo sise igbagbo ninu oko eni kokan
wa. The faith to be saved.
Igbagbo ti
the faith to be sanctified. The faith to be filled and remain full of the Holy Ghost. The faith to be well and to keep healthy. The faith to keep separated from every negative thing in the world. The faith for Jericho walls to fall down. The faith for the sea to part before us. Faith to have answers whenever we pray. Grant us such a faith in Jesus' name. And we pray that you make us to abide in the faith. To live by faith. To walk by faith. Until that very glorious day when by faith we have been walking with you and we are translated out of the world. We pray that from what we saw today, you'll encourage every heart. And you will attach our spirit, our soul, our heart, everything within us to your word, which will never fail in Jesus' name.
And
we pray that our faith will work and produce and receive blessings from you in Jesus' name. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. We welcome every one of you to our Bible study today. Repeat of those who are coming for the first time. Since we started a series from Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11 talks about faith. And it tells us about the importance of faith. In Hebrews 11 verse 6. It says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Nitori eni ti o ba nto Olorun wa ko le sa igbagbo pe o nbe ati pe o ni oluseso fun awon ti o fi ara bale wa.
And this whole chapter is dedicated to the subject of faith.
Gbogbo ri patapata o la fi je fun eko nipa igbagbo.
Verse 1 talks about the definition of faith.
Ese ikini so nipa idaniloju igbagbo.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Oni je igbagbo ni idaniloju a
lot of things we're hoping for. A lot of things that appear invisible now. Before we get them, faith is like the telescope that we take and look at something very, very far away, and that telescope of faith will bring it near unto us. After giving us the definition of faith, he gives us the declaration approving the men of faith. In verse 2, by it the elders obtained a good report. If you are going to be able to receive a good report from the Lord, it is by faith. If you are going to give a good report as well, like Caleb and Joshua, and you will not bring an evil report concerning the the land of promise. And you will not tell us like you are like a grasshopper, while the enemies are like giants. If you are going to give a good report about God, and God will give a good report about you, it is by faith. And then we have the discernment through faith. In verse 3, we discern, we know, we understand. Through faith, we understand that the walls were framed by the word of God. The things that the unbelievers cannot know, that natural man cannot tell, it is our faith that makes us to get into the depths of the knowledge of God, and we know things that unbelievers cannot know. After setting that foundation of faith, telling us the definition and description, telling us the declaration and the discernment, he now shows us some examples of the people that live the life of faith. He gives us the example of Abel to show us the commencement of the life of faith. Tells us by faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. And that is the way we begin the life of faith. We look at that final sacrifice, the perfect sacrifice. Behold the lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Embracing him, clinging to him, relying upon him, you begin the life of faith. And having told us of the commencement of the life of faith, he now tells us of the continuity of the life of faith. And he tells us the characteristics of the continuity of the life of faith. That he shows us in the life of Enoch. Enoch was a person that continued with God and continued walking with God and continued following after God until God took him away and he did not see
there.
And so in verse 5, by faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death and was not found because God had translated him. We see the commencement in Abel, the continuity and the characteristics of the life of faith in Enoch. Now we see the conviction of faith and the courage of the life of faith, the consummation of the life of faith in that of Noah. For in verse 7, by faith Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, he moved with fear and prepared an ark to the saving of his soul,
of his house.
And so you learn that if we're going to end up very well in the Lord, because as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Those who did not have faith in the Lord, they perished in the flood. But Noah and his family, because of their faith in God, they were saved from the judgment of the flood. They entered securely into the ark of safety, into the security of the Lord, before the flood, before the deluge, the rain was poured upon the world. That's the challenge the Lord is giving unto us. Today we are called upon that we allow Christ to dwell in our heart by faith. And that we are to live by faith. Any day of the week, any week of the month, any month of the year, you do not live by faith, it's a lost day, a lost week, a lost month. You must live by faith every day, every moment. And we're told to pray by faith and to pray in faith. Any prayer we pray, and there is no faith inside it, it's a vain prayer. It is like yawning. It is like just speaking out into the ear. It will not amount to anything. Pray in faith.
Gbogbo adura ta ba gba ti o ba si gbagbo nu re a kan fi akoko sofo ni o da bi pe keyan kan yan abi keyan kan soro si afefe lasan.
And we to resist our adversary the devil by faith.
Asin lati koju ija si esu nipa igbagbo.
Resisting the devil, if we don't do it by faith, it will not be effective, it will not be productive, it will not amount to anything. It is by faith we resist the devil.
Ki a koju ija si esu ti ki ba se ninu igbagbo ko ni mu eso kankan jade wa ko ni ni lari kan an lati koju ija si nipa igbagbo.
And not only that, it is by faith we overcome the world.
Ki se eleyi nikan nipa igbagbo la nsegun aye.
And it is by faith we are walking and walking every time, every moment.
Nipa igbagbo o la si rin la ntes waju ni gbogbo igba.
To please God then, we are being told that we are to live the life of faith.
Lati wa wo Olorun nigba na a so fun pe an lati gbegbe aye igbagbo.
And today what we are looking at is a pattern of the life of faith.
Loni o ta wa ngbe yawo ni apere igbe aye igbagbo.
And this pattern is given unto us through the life of Abraham. And the challenge we have in the word of God is that Abraham, he lived by faith. Now can you see what we're studying? If you read Hebrews chapter 11, for Abel, only one verse is devoted to the life of Abel. And as you look at Enoch, only one verse was devoted to the life of Enoch. And as you look at Noah, the consummation, the courage and the conviction of faith, only one verse is devoted telling us about the faith of Noah. But as you now talk about Abraham, some verses are devoted to Abraham, and then a verse is devoted to the life of Sarah. And immediately following, they get back to Abraham again. And then down the verses again, we talk about Abraham. Look at it in verse 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, he obeyed and he went out, not knowing whither he went. Look at verse 9, still talking about him by faith. He sojourned in the land of promise. In verse 10, for he looked for a city which has foundations whose builder and maker is God. In verse 11, through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed. In verse 12, therefore sprang there even of one, him, that's Abraham, now as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky, the multitude. By faith, when he was tried, he offered up Isaac. In verse 19, accounting that God was able to raise him up even from the dead, from whence also he received him in a figure. The point I'm making to you is that if the word of God in that chapter devotes just one verse to Abel, one verse to Enoch, one verse to Noah, and so many verses to Abraham, there is something to learn in the life of Abraham as a pattern of the life of faith.
Ese oro Olorun kan nipa ti Abeli, ese oro Olorun kan na la kan nipa ti Enoch ati ese oro Olorun kan nipa ti Noah. To si wa je pe opolopo awon ese oro Olorun lo so nipa Abraham, o fi e pe apere kan be ninu igbe aye Abraham ta lati keko nu
e. It means that he is a pattern for you and for me.
O si o tumo si pe o je apere fun iwa ati emi.
You know, he was called the friend of God.
O mo pe a pe ni ore Oluwa Olorun.
And it was faith that earned him that title.
Igbagbo re lo si je ki a fi oye yen tete alola.
In Romans chapter 4 verse 12.
Ninu Rome ori kan ese ike
Romans chapter 4 verse 12. And the father of circumcision, to them who are not of the circumcision only, but who also walk in the steps of that faith of our father Abraham, which he had been yet
uncircumcised.
Today we're going to look at verses 8 to 12 of Hebrews chapter 11. And I'm pleading with invite you that you shall come next Monday. Because there are some verses in from verse 13 that seems confusing to people that do not know how to study the word of God.
That's
the reason we're going very slowly, so that we go so deep into the word of God, every confusion in your mind, every doubt in your mind, everything will be swept away by the word of God in Jesus' name.
In
the verses we're looking at today, we're considering 3 points. Number 1, the pilgrimage of faith. The pilgrimage of faith. Number 2, the proof and the patience of faith. And then number 3, the power of faith. I pray that power will work in your life. That power will work in your family. But let's begin at the beginning of the life of Abraham. The pilgrimage of faith. Look at it in verse 8. And as you look at verse 8, let the Spirit of God interpret every detail to you. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should utter receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out not knowing whither he went.
Nipa igbagbo ni Abraham nigba ti ati pe lati jade lo si ibi ti oun yo gba fun ile ini.
You will see here that God called Abraham. The story of the call of Abraham we find in Genesis chapter 12. In Genesis chapter 12 from verse 1. Now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee.
Oluwa si ti wi fun Abraham pe jade kuro ni ile re ati kuro lodo awon ara re ati kuro ni ile baba re si ile kan ti emi o fi han.
We learn something here, that when you are walking by faith, God may not tell you everything that he wants to tell you before you take the first step.
Ohun ti a ri ko ni ni pe bi a ba n gbegbe aye igbagbo, Olorun le ma so gbogbo ohun to fe so fun wa ni igbesi akoko to ba ni ka gbe.
If we are waiting, I want to know more, I want to know more, I want to know more, we are not taking a step of faith.
Ti a ba duro pe mo fe mo won Olorun si, mo fe ri aridaju Olorun si, a gbegbe se igbagbo nigba
na. The Lord called him out of the country.
Olorun pe jade kuro ni ile re.
From the kindred.
Kuro laarin awon eyan re.
From the father's house.
Ati kuro ni ile baba re.
Unto a land.
Si ile kan.
That he had not shown him.
Ile ti o ti fi han.
A land that he had not told him.
Ile ti o ti so nipa
e fun. A land that I will show thee.
Sugbon ile ti emi yo fi han.
He was to take the step of faith first, and then the Lord will show him.
O kokon lati gbe igbese igbagbo na ko to ri pe Olorun yo fi han.
We need to look at some things on this call of Abraham.
A lati wa wo fin ohun kan ninu ipe Abraham.
As the Lord told him, it was a challenge to his
faith.
Number one, he called him out that he might get him in. But we need to understand the word of God. Because there are some people today that will say God called them out of the family of God. No, that's the destination. That's the place God is calling you into. He cannot call you out of the family of God. He can only call you out of the world, out of Egypt, out of the idolatrous land where you are, out of the sinful nature, out of the sinful things around you. He cannot call you out of the family of God. He cannot call you out of his kingdom. What was the life of Abraham in his family before this time? In Joshua chapter 24.
Reading
from verse 2 and verse 3. His family was in idolatry. idolatry.
Àwọn mọ̀lẹ́bí rẹ̀ wọ́n gbégbé ayé ìbọ̀rìṣà
nígbà náà. His surrounding was an idolatrous surrounding.
Àyíká ibi tó ń gbé, àyíká ibi tó dídò
fún ìwà ìbọ̀rìṣà ni. He was living in darkness.
Ó ń gbé nínú òkùnkùn
nígbà náà. And God called him out of darkness.
Ọlọ́run sì pè é jáde kúrò nínú òkùnkùn.
Out of idolatry.
Kúrò nínú ìbọ̀rìṣà.
Out of evil.
Kúrò nínú ìwà ibi.
In Joshua chapter 24 verse 2.
Nínú Joshua orí 24 ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì.
And Joshua said unto all the people, thus says the Lord God of Israel, your fathers dwelt on the other side of the flood in the old time, even Terah, the father of Abraham and the father of Nahor, and they served other gods.
Joshua si wi fun awon eniyan pe bayi ni Oluwa Olorun Israeli wi awon baba yin tin gbe ha keje odo ni atijo ri ani Terah baba Abraham ati baba Nahor.
You see, they were worshipping idols.
Oh, man, one see orisha.
The parents of Abraham were idol worshippers.
And Abraham
was doing what everybody in the family was doing. And the Lord called him out. Out of idolatrous family, not out of the family of God. And then in verse 3, I took your father Abraham from the other side of the flood, where they were worshipping idols, and I led him throughout all the land of Canaan and multiplied his seed and gave him Isaac.
Ese iketa emi si mu Abraham baba yin lati iha keje odo na wa mo si se amona re la gbogbo ile Canaan ija mo si so iru omo re di pupo mo si fun ni Isaac.
In Genesis chapter 12 and verse 4.
Ninu Genesis ori kejila ese ikerin.
So Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken unto him.
Abraham si jade gege bi Oluwa ti soro fun.
Can you see the word of God here?
O wa le ri oro Olorun.
Can you see the manifestation of faith?
Abraham
departed.
Abraham lo.
As the Lord had spoken unto him.
Bi Oluwa ti so fun.
That's prompt obedience by faith.
Eleyi ni igboran nipa igbagbo.
That's a willing obedience by faith.
Eleyi ni ife la nipa igbagbo.
That's walking by faith without any delay.
Eleyi ni ririn nipa igbagbo lai fi akoko
soko. That is responding to the call of God immediately, had a call without any argument.
Eleyi ni ka ko bi ara si pe Olorun ni gere ti o gbo ipe na lai si
aye. And look at the description of his faith.
O si wo
as the Lord has spoken unto him. There was no modification. There was no changing. There was no misinterpretation. If we are going to walk by faith, there will be no modification of the word of God. There will be no misinterpretation of the word of God. As the Lord had spoken unto him. And Lord went with him. And Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran.
Abraham si je ni 65 odun nigba ti o jade ni Haran.
If you think about the implications of that.
Ti o ba ronu nipa ti o je abajade
leyin. When you become so old like that, you don't think of going on a new journey.
Ti eyan ba ti dagba be o ni ronu ati lo si irin ajo to ba
jina. It is inconvenient for old people to break up old association they have made up all through their lives.
O ma nira fun awon ti o ba ti dagba lagba lati yera kuro.
And it is very difficult to forsake the old life and leave the loved ones behind. He was living the present certainty for a future uncertainty. Do you realize how embarrassing it would have been? If the neighbors asked him, his friends asked him, you are living certainty. Do you know where you are going? Can you describe it to us? Can you give us the name? And Abraham will say, I'm just following God step by step. What he has told me now is what I know. He'll tell me the rest when I get out.
Abraham
And this is a challenge for us. Actually, the Lord is calling us. There are three definite calls that come to every child of God today. And these three calls, they go in order. Number one, then number two, then number three. God will not give you the second call except you obey the first call. And the third call is not going to come until by faith you have responded to the first and the second. Number one is the call to salvation. In Luke chapter 5 and verse 32. I came not to call the righteous but sinners to repentance. That's the same call the Lord is giving today. He's calling the person that is not born again, is calling him, is calling her unto repentance, unto salvation. As it was not convenient for the flesh, for Abraham, it's not going to be convenient for the flesh for you. You have been in the nice club all your life. You have been drinking, smoking all your life. You have had a sin partner's girlfriend or women friend or men friend all your life. And you have been fraudulent all your life. You have been idolatrous all your life. And you have association with worldly people. People that speak the vanity of the things of life, and they are pursuing after the bubbles of life of the world. You have been following them all your life. Now the Lord is calling you. And he tells you that friendship of the world is enmity with God. It's not going to be easy for the flesh. Carnal reasoning will say, if I leave this, what am I going to gain? There is a lot you are going to gain, but you will not understand now. Because the natural man does not know, does not understand the depth of the riches of the glory of God that we are going to get. It is by faith we come out of the world. And we come out of sin. And when you come out like that, you come out promptly. The moment the Lord is calling you. And then as the Lord has spoken unto him, there will be no misinterpretation of the call. There will be no modification of the call. Wholeheartedly. Promptly. Willingly. Without argument. Without any question. You come out of your sin and you surrender yourself to the Lord.
That's
the call the Lord is giving to everyone, is a call to salvation. There is a second call after we are saved. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verse 7. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 7. For God has not called us unto uncleanness but unto holiness. He calls us now, number two, unto sanctification. Number one, unto salvation. Number two, unto sanctification. When he tells you about the Adamic nature that is still within, when he tells you that you need to walk closer unto him, when he tells you he's giving you a holy calling, an heavenly calling, a high calling into the holiness life of Christ, you will not abandon that call to sanctification and then go into service, activity, because after salvation, the next call that comes is sanctification. You must go step by step. The third call is a call to service. Number one, to salvation. Number two, to sanctification. Number three is unto service. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, reading from verse 2. And as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them.
Bi won si tin josin fun Oluwa ti won si n gbawe emi mo wi pe eya banaba o solu soto fun mi fun ise ti mo ti pe won si.
Everything that when the Lord calls you,
nigba ti Oluwa ba pe o,
every time the Lord calls,
nigbogbo igba ti o ba pe,
if he calls you to salvation,
to ba pe o si igala,
he wants you to walk by faith,
o fe ko rin nipa igbagbo,
take the step of faith,
ko gbegbe se igbagbo,
be prompt about it,
ko yara kankan nipa,
do it willingly,
ko se pelu
ifokore, do it immediately,
ko se loju ese,
then he calls you to sanctification,
to ba pe o si isodi mimo,
do it immediately,
ko se loju ese,
without delay, and then he calls you into service. Oh, you will not complain about the economy of today.
Hey,
you will not say, I can't give any other time to the Lord. I can't do any evangelism now. Look at the condition, look at the condition of my family. Here is a challenge that Abraham is giving us. At the age of 75, the Lord called him. And in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8, By faith, Abraham. Before your name, if faith can come there, it will be a wonderful walk with the Lord. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, he obeyed. That word obeyed, that's the proof of his faith. And then he went out, telling us it was practical obedience. It was not obedience in word, obedience at the time of prayer. Oh Lord, I will obey you. Oh Lord, I will do everything you want me to do. Obedience only in promise, but obedience in practical terms. He went out.
Then he
says, not knowing. Not walking by sight. Not knowing. Not knowing whither he went. He knew that the Almighty was before him. Actually, he said it another time. And he said, the angel that led me when I walked with God, when I came out, it was the Lord leading him. He went out not knowing whither he went. Now we look at point number two. The proof and patience of faith. The proof and patience of faith. I need to tell you that faith is connected with patience. Without patience, there will be no faith. Have you found some people, especially young people, children? They have seen that some farmers, they grow maize. And if you are going to grow maize like that, you need to have faith. Faith that if you put that corn in the ground, you are not throwing it away, it's going to germinate. That when you hide it under the soil, although you cannot see it anymore, God is working on it. And then you go back home to sleep, and you sleep all through the night, not worrying your mind, what is happening to that seed now? Faith will leave that seed there under the soil for it to come up. And as the sun is shining and as the rain is falling, the faith is there that the sun is not going to destroy the seed and the rain is not going to destroy the seed. The sun, the rain, they're going to combine together to make the seed to grow up and to bring forth fruit.
And
you are patient until that fruit will come
out.
We need faith like that, that will be demonstrated by patience. Now look at Hebrews chapter 11, verse 9. By faith, he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country. You see, he was in the land where God called him. And yet he didn't have the full possession of it. He was living there as if it was still a strange land, a strange country. Dwelling in tabernacles, dwelling in tents. Now, can you see there the temporary nature of where he was dwelling? Even though the whole land belongs to him, he had not built a solid house there as yet. He was patient until the inheritance will fully become his.
O wa ri ohun ti igbagbo se ninu aye re ni iye nigba ti o n gbe ile ilerijo Olorun ti se leri fun gege bi eni pa le joni lori ile na to si n fi suru duro nigba ti gbogbo re yo fi bo si ikawo
re. He was dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise.
O n gbe inu ago pelu Isaac ati Jacob, awon ajogun ileri kan na pelu re.
And we read that story in Genesis chapter 13.
Aka itan ninu Genesis ori ketala.
After he came out.
Leyin igba to jade.
Genesis chapter 13, reading from verse 12.
Genesis ori ketala, anka lati ese ikejila.
Genesis 13 verse 12.
Genesis ori ketala ese ikejila.
And Abraham dwelt in the land of Canaan.
Abraham si joko ni ile Kenani.
And then in verse 14.
Ni ese ikejila.
And the Lord said unto Abraham, after that Lot was separated from him, lift up now thine eyes and look from the place where thou art northward, and southward, and eastward, and westward, for all the land which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever.
Ese ikerinla Oluwa si wi fun Abrahamu leyin igba ti Lot ya kuro lodo re tan pe gbe oju re soke ni isisin ki o si wo lati ibi ti o gbe wa ni lo si iha riwa ati si iha gusu ati si iha ila orun ati si iha iwo orun gbogbo ile ti o ri ni iwo ni emi o si fi fun ati fun iru omo re lai lai.
If you look at verse 15 very well, the tense there is future tense. I will give, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. It was still to be future.
Ti o ba wo ese ikedogun daada o ri pe gbolohun ti Olorun lo nbe gbolohun ti o sele lojo waju ni iwo ni emi o sa fi fun ati fun.
Look at verse 17. Arise, walk through the land in the length of it and in the breadth of it, for this is a future tense again. I will give it unto thee. Do you see there was no complaint in Abraham? Do you know that he was patiently waiting for the fulfillment of that promise? In fact, he was so fully persuaded, he was giving glory to God.
In
verse 18, then Abraham removed his tent and came and dwelt in the land in the plain of Mamre, and which is in Hebron, and he built there an altar unto the Lord.
Esa ikejidilogun nigba na ni Abraham si ago re o si wa o si joko ni igbo Mamre ti o wa ni Hebroni o si te pepe kan nibe fun Oluwa.
What was the altar for?
Kini pepe wa fun?
For the worship adoration of the Lord.
Fun isin fun ibo ati fun yin Olorun.
He kept on glorifying the Lord.
O bere si ni yin Olorun
loko. He knew that God will not fail.
O me pe Olorun o ni kuna.
That God will not lie.
Pe Olorun o ni se pe.
I am there already.
Ipe mo ti wa nbe na.
But then he said, I will give it unto you.
O ni sugbe emi yo fi fun.
He said, look north, look south, look to the west and look to the east. Everything you see as far as your eyes can carry you, to you will I give everything. And he worshipped the Lord.
Only wo iha riwa ki o si wo iha gusu wo iha ila orun ko wo iha iwo orun ibi ti oju re ba le ri na mo ebe ni emi o fi fun o o si wa tepe pe o bere si ni se Olorun.
There's something wonderful about the faith of Abraham.
Nkan kan je agbayanu nipa igbagbe Abraham.
I want you now to come back to Hebrews chapter 11 and see.
Mo fe ko pada wa si Eberu ori kokanla ko wa wo.
You see, the Lord had been talking about the land of promise.
O ma Olorun ti so nipa ile ileri.
And that land of promise was here on earth, is here on earth.
Ibi ile ileri ta si so yi lori ile aye nbi
ni. Said, walk up and down in it. Look as far as the north, as far as the south, as far as the west, as far as the east. And when the Lord told him to look, see how he looked. Come back now for to Hebrews chapter 11 verse 10. For he looked. Now, what was he looking for? He looked for a city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. He wasn't just looking at things here on earth. He was looking at things in heaven. He knew that for what God has promised here on earth, he was going to get it. Then he looked beyond the earth and he was looking for a city up in heaven whose builder and maker is God. You see, it was by faith that Abraham got to the land. It was by faith he remained in the land. land. And his faith stretched beyond the physical scene, beyond the land of promise, and then looked to the heavenly city, and he desired a heavenly city. If he had wanted to go back, he could have gone back. He waited for years, he was still waiting. And even though he had not got all the whole land, if you have read the whole of Genesis before, you will realize that when he wanted to bury the dead, he even had to buy with his money out of the land. And yet God had given him everything. He was not going to do it by himself. He was not going to do it by any force. He was going to allow the time of God to come, and God was going to give him everything. That's the patience of faith. The ability to wait for the time of God. The ability to allow God to do it himself. The ability for God to wait until God will do what he decides to do. The ability to wait without complaining. Be sure beyond any shadow of doubt what he has said, he will definitely do it. The ability to keep on rejoicing before we see the physical manifestation. The ability to keep on serving God. Raising an altar to God. Worshipping the Lord. Glorifying the Lord. Knowing that he has said it and that's no problem. And it is not something we're going to be talking about every day. He has promised he will do it. He cannot fail. In Romans chapter 4 verses 20 and 21. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but he was strong in faith, giving glory to God. Building altar, worshipping the Lord, glorifying the Lord. Why was he doing that? Being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. We're going to look at the power of faith. Faith is mighty and powerful. Did you hear that the Red Sea was divided? Faith is powerful. Did you hear that water came out of the dry rock? Faith is powerful. Did you hear that the Jericho walls fell down? Faith is powerful. Did you hear that God fed his people for 40 years without they planting anything or reaping any harvest? Faith is mighty and powerful. Did you hear that Sarah became pregnant when all hope had been lost? Faith is mighty and powerful. Did you hear that God created this whole world out of nothing? Faith is powerful. If you will have faith with God, all things are possible in your life. All those things you have been worried about in the past is unbelief that brings worry and anxiety. Faith will never lead us to worry and anxiety. Let's look at the power of faith. The power of faith. It says through faith, also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed. Isn't it a wonderful thing? What we say about the husband, we're saying about the wife. Look at verse 8, by faith, Abraham. Look at verse 11, through faith, also
Sarah.
It's wonderful when a husband and a wife will agree together, moving in the same direction of faith. Because one shall chase 1,000 and two shall put 10,000 to flight. Because if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that you ask of the Father, he will do it unto you. And so through faith also Sarah received. Did you see that word receive? Come back to verse 8. By faith Abraham, when he was called to go out into a land, into a place which he should after receive. Can you see the same word used for Abraham and used for Sarah? Abraham received, that's by faith. Sarah received, that's by faith. And then in verse 11, through faith also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed. And was delivered of a child when she was past age. When it appeared impossible. When it appeared it was not normal anymore. When it appeared there should be no expectation anymore. When it appeared they were telling him, have you ever found anybody like that? Why are you hoping against hope? Why are you deceiving yourself? Why are you making religion to cover up? Don't you say God has promised something? God has promised something. Don't you see how old you are? Don't you see your body has changed? Don't you know you are not a lady anymore? And it is not with you, not like with other ladies. But she received strength. When it says she received strength to conceive. That means that her body normally was not functioning the same way the bodies of young ladies are functioning. And the things that will make her to be pregnant, and all the things within the body that will allow pregnancy, all those things are sub-functioning. By faith, a creative miracle was done. The thing that has taught in her body started functioning. The creative miracle took place. And it was by faith she received that strength to conceive and was even delivered of a child when she was past age, this is faith, because this is the foundation of the faith, because this is the reason for having faith, because she judged him faithful who had promised. She judged him faithful who had promised. He said, our God cannot lie. And I want to tell you, our God cannot lie. She said, our God cannot fail. And I want to assure you, your God cannot fail. She said, my God will not disappoint me. And I want to tell you, your God will not disappoint you. Because she said, she judged him faithful that had promised. And therefore, we are told, therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead. So many as the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seaside, which is by the seashore, innumerable. And now I want you to understand the language of verse 12. It's trying to give us the description of the answer to their faith. It's trying to tell us the fulfillment of the promise of God. And in telling us about the answer, about the response, about the fulfillment to the promise of God in their life, he describes it, saying the same thing in three ways. Number one, he says, innumerable. That is, God answered their prayer. God fulfilled their desires. God accomplished his promise. And he gave them Isaac. And from Isaac came Jacob. And from Jacob the 12. And from the 12 the nation. From the nation innumerable people. In describing the innumerable people, he also says, as the stars of the sky in multitude. multitude is the same thing, innumerable. He also says it another way, as the sand which is by the seashore. Also, that means innumerable. Do you see what faith can do? Do you see when they had lost hope? When people should have been telling them, why are you still hoping? Why are you still expecting? You take this religion in a fanatical way. Doctor told you it's not possible. Your body is giving you sign it is not possible. Everything has stopped functioning in your body, you know it is not possible. Even people that look at you, they know it is not possible. Why are you fanatical? It is faith. I said it is faith. That God can do the impossible. And if you will believe tonight, you will prove that all your neighbors are liars, but God is true. See how Moses told the children of Israel concerning the fulfillment of the promise in Deuteronomy chapter 1 and in verse 10. Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 10. The Lord your God has multiplied you, and behold, ye are this day as the stars of heaven for multitude.
I
believe that if the Lord fulfilled his promise at that time, he will fulfill his promise today.
Now
you see the central word we have considered today on the faith of Abraham and
Sarah.
You see that Abraham received the promise and Sarah received strength. You look at that word receive, and the Bible says that we receive Christ. How do we do that? By faith. As many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. How do they do that? As many as believed on his name. If
they
are going to receive Christ, receive salvation, it is by faith. How do we receive the forgiveness of sins, the remission of sins, the pardon for our sins, and the power of sin is broken in our lives, and the remembrance of the sin is cleansed away, and the sin that has been dragging us back into the mud, the power is broken. Again, you receive by faith. In Acts chapter 10 verse 43, to him give all the prophets witness that through his name whosoever believeth, you know it's by faith, you see it's by faith, you understand it's by faith, he that believeth in him shall receive remission of sins. How do we receive the abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness? Again, it is by faith. And look at Hebrew, look at Romans chapter 5, and in verse 17, for if by one man's offense death reigned by one, more they which receive, that's the word receive, again, receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign by one Jesus Christ. If you're going to receive that abundance of grace, again, it is by faith you are going to receive it. How do you receive an inheritance among them that are sanctified? That is, become sanctified and become counted with the sanctified people and receive inheritance among them that are sanctified. Again, it is by faith. In Acts of the Apostles chapter 26 and in verse 18, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive the forgiveness of sins and inheritance
among them which are sanctified by faith that is in Christ, that is in me. It was Christ talking to Paul.
Ati ogo pelu awon ti a so di mimo nipa igbagbo ninu mi ninu Christi. Christi lo nba Paul soro ni.
How do you receive the power of the Holy Ghost?
Bawo la se le gbagbara
e mi mo. The gift of the Spirit.
Ebo emi.
It is again by faith.
Ele pa pa nipa igbagbo
ni. You receive the gift of the Spirit.
Ipe ki a le gba ebo emi mi mo.
For the promises unto you.
Tori fun yin ni ileri
na. And to your children.
Ati fun awon
omo yin. Even as many as the Lord our God shall call.
Ani fun iyeju awon eni ti Oluwa Olorun wa
yo pe. How do you receive the promise of healing?
Bawo lo se le gba ileri
iwosan. The promise of deliverance.
Ileri
the promise for childbearing. The promise for provision. Any other promise the Lord has made for us. Again, it is by faith. How do we receive the fullness of grace? The fullness of strength? The fullness of power? The fullness of Christ? The fullness of blessing? The fullness of the riches of God in glory? Of His fullness have we all received. Why are we staying at the shore? When we can launch into the deep, into the sea of God's abundance, and receive today. Today you can receive. I say today you can receive. All by faith. All by faith. All by faith. If you leave the shore, if you leave the world, if you leave all those things behind, and you launch into the deep with the Lord tonight, you are going to receive before you go. And the Lord will pour the abundance of blessing upon you. It will saturate your heart. It will saturate your life. It will saturate your family. He will give you the abundance from heaven. You will receive of the abundance coming from heaven. Why don't you tell the Lord? Why don't you rise up and tell the Lord? I will not remain dry. I will not remain weak. I will not remain lukewarm. I will not remain cold. I will not remain helpless. I will not remain empty. I will not remain powerless. I will not remain without strength. I'm going to receive. I'm going to receive. I'm going to receive. And it is by faith. And it is by faith. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Look up to Him. Look up to Him. Accept what He has done for you. And you can come and receive from the Lord by faith tonight. Everything we get from salvation to sanctification to spirit baptism to healing to deliverance to children to power to strength to anointing even to heaven. Everything we receive of the riches of glory, of the riches of the kingdom, of the mysteries of the provision of the Lord, everything we receive will receive by faith. Look away from natural things. Look away from your body that appears weak and dead. Look away from society that appears poor. Look away from the economy. Look away from all the people around you. And look unto the Lord. And look unto the Lord. And look unto the Lord. And believe the Lord. The Lord is calling you. If you have not been born again, He's calling you to salvation. If you have not been sanctified, He's calling you to sanctification. If you have not started in the service of the Lord, He's calling you into service. If you have not been healed, He's calling you to receive healing. If you have not been delivered, He's calling you to receive deliverance. If there is any need, any lack in your life, He's calling you to the abundance of the riches of the kingdom of God. Come in. Come in and enjoy the blessing. Come in and embrace the blessing. You don't need to be spiritually shallow anymore. You can launch into the deep with the Lord. Receive from the Lord today. 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 You must not go away empty handed. The Lord has promised you. Stand upon the promises. Claim the promises. Hold on to the promises. Embrace the promises. Receive the promises. Believe the promises. Standing on the promises of God that cannot fail. Receive it by faith. Receive it by faith. Receive it by faith. And then after that, you build your altar, worshiping the Lord, glorifying the Lord, rejoicing in the Lord that the Lord has answered. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but he was giving glory to God, rejoicing, knowing that he that has promises also able to perform.
Believe as you are praying.
Believe as you are praying. Have faith in God.
And
by faith we receive blessings from the Lord.